Good evening, everyone. Welcome to the Prudential Committee monthly meeting. Today, Thursday, May 12th, 2016. On the agenda right now, we're going to meet with John Pachurk first, and then we'll continue the rest of our review of the minutes, old business, new business, chief report, and signing of the warrant. Mr. Pachurk, sir, you are on.
Thank you.
How may I assist you?
I come because I want to talk to you and see if I can convince you of a couple of things.
Good.
What happens is, I think it's been reported that the ambulance has been with this fire department for 47 years. I don't know if that's true or not.
1973. That's when we started.
Okay. So 73, that's 40 something years. Close enough, 45, 46.
It's been a while.
Don't make much difference other than the fact that one of my concerns is, and I remember this pretty clearly, that you're going to go up on the rent, the skims,
yes,
on July 1st.
That's correct.
So I'm asking you to roll that back a little bit. And there's several reasons for it.
Okay.
Number one, I think, first of all, if I remember correctly, they said that you went out and did a study and found out that that's the retail value of rental property for the amount of space that you have. Is that kind of correct?
Correct. It wasn't retail space. It was based off of warehouse and office.
Right.
Yep.
So my point is this, that we really have a situation of a fire department and an EMT department, and I see them going at odds, and for some reason they don't seem to be doing exactly the same thing as they're doing in other towns. For example, the ambulance runs out of the fire department in Greenfield. You go to Amherst, the ambulance runs out of the fire department in Amherst. You go to Northampton, same thing. So the question is, why are we kind of polarizing and going in opposite directions? Like, for example, one thing I tried to do was I tried to get to keep the ambulance in Deerfield. The main reason for that was for time. Now, I went out and got some signatures at the dump. It took about 2 hours to get over 200 signatures. I think there's 209 or 210 signatures. Majority of people, other than two people, come in that they want to keep the ambulance in Deerfield. The two that dissented, one says, well, I don't know enough about the issue, so I'm not going to sign the petition because I just don't know enough about it. That's fine, because you can't force anybody to sign anything. They either want to sign or they don't. And the second guy says, well, my daughter lives in Whately. This is an advantage to Whately, so I'd rather see the money go over to Whately than stay in Deerfield. So that was his argument. He said, besides, I don't like our taxes in town. They're getting to be too expensive, so I think I'm going to leave and buy a house in Whately. So whatever he's got to do, he's got to do. But my concern is that I see this polarizing and going in the opposite directions. Part of it is because the issue of going to Whately, they say they can service all of South Deerfield just as well from there as it from here. That to me is not true.
Yeah, a four minute difference, but yeah.
Well, that's exactly what I said before, 4 minutes. Well, what they said was, they said with lights and sirens, we can make that in 30 seconds. So if they can do that in 30 seconds, they could be going over 100 miles an hour, and I don't think that's very fair to have them driving an ambulance over 100 miles an hour, especially in the switchbacks over by Pine Street.
Sure.
So to me, it makes no sense. Mm-hmm. And everything that I've tried to do, even when we had the special town meeting, was to be 100% true, 100% accurate, make sure there's no misrepresentations, because the article that I wrote said, I want the selectmen to stop misinforming the people about what's really going on. And since then, they decided that even though the motion passed to keep the ambulance in Deerfield, they still turned around and said, well, that was only instructions for officers, so we're going to ignore it anyway. Now, my concern is that anybody west of 91, anybody north of this fire station, it's going to take 3 to 4 minutes longer. Anybody that's got a heart attack that's on that side of the highway or north of here, going to take 3 or 4 minutes longer. That may be the difference between life and death. Now, if we're paying 52%, which is what we're paying, I feel it's only appropriate and fair that we keep the ambulance where the bulk of the people are. The bulk of people are right here in South Deerfield. and we service it from there. Why send the ambulance to another town, a smaller town? And I have a lot of heartburn with a lot of other agreements that they have, like, for example, the 33% vote, but 52% payout. That, to me, was one of the most ridiculous things I've ever heard. But yet they still feel that that's totally adequate. And my concern is that if Whately says, I make a motion that we put this ambulance in Whately, at their highway facility or their new town office, and someone says, yeah, that's closer for me, I second the motion, guess what? Town of Deerfield has to go along with it. We're paying a majority, but we got 1/3 vote. Now, since then, they've tried to soften the blow and say, oh, well, we're going to make the third member a voting member now. So instead of 33%, now it's going to 43%, but they won't give us what we deserve, which is the 52% vote. That 52% vote was established, and it's done by the Franklin Regional Council of Governments. They have a weighted percentage for number of people and value. And could you imagine asking the Mayor Martin to turn around and say, oh, there's 26 towns in here, so instead of you getting 16% or 20% of the vote, we're gonna give you 4% of the vote. Do you think he would say yes to that? I kind of doubt it. So the bottom line is that what's fair for an assessment for the ambulance? I'm not sure what the answer is to that. This I could depend on you guys to tell me. Now, for example, when you charge $18,000, did you make money? Did you lose money? I don't know if you know, or if you've ever figured it out, or if you even care.
Right. I can honestly say I don't think we've actually done an analysis of the two exactly. But the bottom line is we're going off of... I'm sorry, go ahead. I'll let you continue and then...
No, go ahead, answer.
Okay.
You want to do? Since I did most of the
legwork. Yeah, that'd be fantastic.
So when this first came about, when they started talking about South County EMS, we went out to the market, we figured out what the per square foot rent costs were. Yep. And came back to the Prudential Committee, and for the common space that they share here and for their dedicated space, came out to about $36,000 the rent. We felt as though we never charged Deerfield Rescue or the town of Deerfield any money, but since this was gonna be a three-town operation, you know, we decided to give a 50% discount. We're all paying taxes into it. None of the other towns stepped up and did that. So we were getting $18,000, Sunderland, I think, is getting $11,000. Correct me if I'm wrong.
That's right.
And Whately's getting six?
Three.
$3,200. So the reason why Sunderland wanted more money was because they were going to house the backup ambulance. And the thought process was when the primary ambulance went out of the station, that the backup ambulance would be staffed.
Right.
Never happened. Maybe twice in 2 years they had crews down there in that station. I asked Tom Fidakevitz when he came up here and met with us if he was going to offer a discount or reimburse any of that money. He said no. I said, now they're scheduling from 10 o'clock to 6 p.m., 10 in the morning to 6 p.m., 7 days a week, they're scheduling that second ambulance, someone to staff it. You know what they do? They drive down there, they pick up that ambulance, and they drive it up to this fire station. So now there's three people in this station opposed to two. So in my estimation, the town of Sunderland's getting a free ride here. They're getting, you know, almost triple or more than triple what the town of Whately's getting, and all they're doing is parking an ambulance. It's a garage, and they're getting $11,000 for a garage. No wear and tear on their station, nothing. And, you know, for us to go up, so we said we'd give a discount at year one. We would go back and we'd take a look at it for years two and three. It was a three-year lease. Year two came along, they went, town of Sunderland got an escalator, town of Whately, I think, remained the same, yep. And they built in our budget at $18,000. Never came back to us as we asked. So, you know, looking at that, we said we were gonna stand firm with the $36,000. It was already voted on at town meeting, so in order for us to increase the rent, we're gonna have to have special meetings. We didn't wanna incur that cost. You know, we were trying to be a good neighbor here, but we're looking out for our fair value. So, I mean, if the other towns want to take a look at it, I think the South Deerfield Fire District would entertain it. If it was the town of Deerfield's ambulance, and it was only the town of Deerfield's ambulance, your rent would be zero. So there wouldn't be a rent here. So as soon as Soon as it turned into that enterprise fund with the other towns, that's when we started to charge rent.
And I totally agree with you, and you're 100% accurate, and everything that you said is totally true, and there's no argument there at all. My only concern is that after you look at the 100% increase, one other way to look at it is, look, you have two sister services. You have life-saving services from the fire department, which goes out and saves houses and saves people. The ambulance service, which saves people. And if we're lucky enough to work together, then maybe we could turn around and find some efficiencies which would help us. But my concern is that trying to keep the ambulance in town, I can't go to, I've gone to SCEMS trying to get some changes, and every time I've tried to get changes, I get totally ignored. And I know you guys are more gentlemanly, so I know that you won't ignore me. You may blow me off, you will turn around and at least listen, and we can discuss this thing.
So, I mean, one of the things we've done in the meantime is we've reached out to Franklin County, the COG, about doing a study to combining the Deerfield Fire District, the South Deerfield Fire District, and South County EMS into one organization. They will not fund that study because they said they've already funded a study for South County EMS and they're not going to put more money into that until it has its fair share. So they have been, still haven't gotten back to them, or they haven't gotten back to us in regards to the combining Deerfield Fire Department and South Deerfield Fire Department.
That's good to know because I didn't know that.
They did not want to destabilize what was already been put together, was, I believe it was the quote was how it was put to me. Because they spent all that time and they spent the money to go ahead and do the study for South County EMS, and they did not want another study to come along and tear South County EMS apart. And I tried to explain to them that wasn't the intent. And that's basically the way that they accepted it. So I was like,
okay.
All right.
So back in January or February before I went on vacation, I put in a request for the fire district to put in $10,000 to fund our own study. Because at that time I was going to go to the COG and ask them to look at the study. And the only reason is because you guys are growing, South County is growing, and why not try and grow together and make this a concerted effort so we can work together rather than fighting and splitting apart and going in opposite directions.
And I think we're in 100% agreement with that. I mean, the one thing that the fire district wants to do is we want to have as many questions answered before putting our foot in the water. I think that's one of the reasons why South County EMS is in, it's where they are today, and the issues that they're having is, I think they put the cart before the horse, and they wanted to start this before they answered all the questions, you know, and the response I got when I asked that was, well, you had to start sometime. And, you know, to me, it wasn't the right time to start. Another year, another 2 years of ironing all this stuff out. You know, we had the service. Deerfield had enough money to pay for, you know, the additional people, you know, to staff it. You know, and they just jumped at this. And it was the first thing that came along. When it went to town meeting vote, you know,
watch what you say, because you know what they're going to say? That you're thinking too much like Pachurk, so we got to get rid of that too.
I mean, I just, the way it was brought to town meeting was, you know, they had two articles. Yeah. They voted the first one through and the second article went away. And it confused a lot of people, because I think there was a lot of people that would have voted for the Deerfield only article after. And
if you analyze exactly what's going on finance-wise, you'll find last year they ended up with almost $503,000 extra out of a $1.1 million budget. Now, if you don't call that a lot of fat in a budget, I don't know what you call it. Because you guys don't have that. I was working with you guys for 10, 15 years, 12 or 14 years, I think. And we never had that kind of fat in a budget.
No, we still don't. We just try to account for everything and try to plan for all our expenses as they come along.
That's why I said, I figured I could come here and talk to you because I know how good you guys have done. You've done an excellent job at management, and that's exactly what we need. And I haven't seen the same thing going on with SCEMS. And if you look at SCEMS, one of the things they did when the police study came out, they brought out the fact, they says, listen, if the agreement that you have does not, If everybody can't get on board with that agreement because it's not a good agreement, you're doomed to fail. Now with this 33% fiasco being 52%, a lot of people aren't happy with that. They never have been happy with that, but they just kind of go along with it because there's nothing they can do. But if you turn around and take that and extrapolate it out, sooner or later it's going to come to a head and people are going to say, enough's enough, there's too much fat in the budget. The town of Deerfield could run their own EMS department for probably in the summer in $700,000 neighborhood. If we didn't take anything out of year one out of their budget, and we took nothing out in year two, how much extra do you think they'll have for year two? They're going to have about the same thing, except they didn't spend the money on the ambulance yet. So that's another $285,000, and another $100,000 free cash that they haven't spent. So they're going to be $900,000 or better. At the rate they're funding, they could buy three new ambulances in 3 years. And meanwhile, they just don't seem to care. They want to do what they want to do. And I know that I could come here and at least talk reason with you guys and say, maybe there's nothing I can do with SCEMS, but maybe there's something we can do here. And all I'm looking for is two things. Number one, I'm asking for consideration of reducing the SCEMS rent. Like, for example, if $18,000 was okay last year, maybe it could go up to $19,000 or $20,000. Or if it's $16,000, instead of doubling it, go up somewhat and make this thing a little more easy on the SCEMS so that they can go for at least another year. And the better you can make it, the better it is for us, the better it is for everybody in this room who's a taxpayer. Because you're paying both for the town of Deerfield and you're paying a fire district tax. And of the town of Deerfield tax, we're still paying 52% of it. So I'm asking for you to roll back that thing. And where you want to roll it back, something better than nothing.
Well, actually, in a way, we have rolled it back because we didn't get the increase we were supposed to get a year ago.
I know that. I agree that. That's absolutely true. But what I'm saying is going into year three, I'm looking to see if you can sweeten the pot and set the example for them, because you guys are better at budgeting and managing than they ever have been. Even when they came up and their director came up and says, I got proposals to cut the budget, the Board of Oversight said, no, you're not cutting the budget one bit. They want to keep all the fat built into the budget. That's part of the issue. You guys have the leadership capability and you can do this thing and you know how to manage and budget money where they don't. Now that's the difference between you guys and those guys.
The reason why I'm kind of chuckling is because
you're laughing at me, right?
No. Actually, the part I'm kind of chuckling about is because you're saying on how they're fat and you want us to save them money, and they've got the money to pay us, one. Two, like you said, so 2 years we've already done it at half price.
I know that.
Now we've gone into year three, which was supposed to be actually year two's cost.
Yeah,
again, they have the money to do this. And then we also gave them the opportunity to extend one more year into the fourth year just to make sure that if something didn't happen within those 3 years, they gave an extra year to be able to go ahead and find their own housing, which is the original agreement, and correct me if I'm wrong, the original agreement that we made with South County EMS when they decided to become South County EMS. The other side of the coin is we collectively need to think about the district also, because that's $36,000 offsets our district, which is you and I. And
money we don't have to raise from taxes.
Right. So in other words, if we go ahead and we give them a little bit more of a break, now we're going to have to raise our rate. It's going to be very little, but now we're going to have to charge our district more money, and that's not fair to the district. So we've already given them...
We gave them an extra year.
Yeah, we gave them an extra year to actually physically be here, which is beyond the original contract. The second year, so basically they got 2 years for the price of 1 year.
Based on
16 and
16. Commercial rate, but the commercial rate is a fallacy because this should not be construed as the same thing as renting the tower out there. When you rent the tower out there, you're renting it to a profit-making business who's making money off it. SCEMS doesn't make any money off their calls.
Right.
They're a loss leader, like you guys are loss leaders.
Right.
Everybody's paying taxes for the same service. So if everybody's paying taxes for it, and it's a loss leader, I don't think you've got them in the right category. Your calculations are right, but I don't think they're in the right category I think you should probably look at it differently and say, maybe what we ought to do is, let's take a look at rolling it back because they're a sister service.
Then if that's the case, then Sunderland should do it and so should Whately because they use the same formula that we used.
That's probably a good idea.
That I can't argue with that.
And that is how, because originally when Bill did a phenomenal job as far as putting it together, knowing what retail space goes for, what rents go for because of the business that he's in. When we went ahead and looked at the square footage to the amount of money that Sunderland was originally trying to do, the numbers didn't match up. So that's when we collectively stomped our feet and said, hey, listen, you know, it has to be the same all the way around the board because we're not going to do it differently. Everyone has to be able to do it the same exact way by your square footage on what you say you're going to be using.
Yeah.
So at the 11,500, 800, whatever it is that Sunderland's getting right now, they're including their restrooms, they're including their break room, they're including their conference room, the kitchen, the whole nine yards.
I have no idea. I didn't look at the formula.
Which is the only way they're going to be able to get up to, I mean, because otherwise it should be the same exact price as Whately, $3,000, if it's going by square footage, going based off of the same square footage formula.
For work area.
But they're not staffing that. They're not staffing, so they shouldn't be charging for those expenses for a year.
So the long and the short is that some of this is a collective, you know, and it's not just the district that has this issue. It's the town should be looking into this as far as South County EMS is concerned, breaking up the differences, you know, because if we're going to give a break, then they have to give a break. They're not going to give a break, we're not going to give a break, because we're going to do the right thing for our district, because that's who we're here for. We are here for our district. We're not here for the town, technically. Are we there for mutual aid for the town? Are we there to do whatever we can for the town? Certainly we are. But technically, our group is for the district, and that's who we have to protect, and that's who we have. Because again, otherwise, if we give them a discount, now we're going to have to raise the rates, and that's going to go on the back of the district. And that's not fair to the district. Correct me if I'm wrong.
No, you're right.
Yeah.
So.
I guess you blew me out of the water on that one.
Sorry. No.
And I mean, you know, in the long, well, what's your second point?
Why does the fire department not want to have EMS part of it?
So I think in the future, you're 100% right. It all needs to be under one roof. But yeah, like I said before, we want to make sure we have all our answers. You know, so then that way, you know, we're not running into any of these issues. There's a lot of stuff. You know, if the town of Deerfield wanted to take it over, you know, just for the town of Deerfield and turn it over to the South Deerfield Fire District, you know, our concern would be, okay, now, you know, South Deerfield Fire District, you know, this one little entity out of the town of Whately, town of Sunderland, you know, Deerfield Fire Protection District and us, if all of a sudden we're subsidizing going mutual aid all the time,
yep,
what did the district gain? You know, so, you know, I think, you know, without knowing their, you know, accounting and stuff like that, I mean, we don't want to take the taxpayers of the district and have them subsidize and have to pay more money for other towns' benefit. So, and I think that's...
Is there any way that you could consider possibly putting, housing two ambulances up here and possibly building another building on site for some of the equipment that you rarely use or some of the antiques or anything?
Actually,
and can at least house two ambulances here and work on that sort of scenario, at least for maybe a 5 to 6 year period, because I mean,
well, I think a lot of
even in Whately, they said that is only a temporary housing situation,
yeah, and I think
until some studies get done about possibly putting all this in one roof, because unfortunately, once it moves out of town, it's gone forever. Okay.
You know, one thing that should be looked at too is the town owns the property right next door.
Right.
Space is a big issue here because of you know, their needs and our needs too. And actually, with the amount of money that the towns and everything are paying for rent, you can almost build a building out there from the town of Deerfield stuff and pay for it with the amount of money that they're spending now.
I mean, if they were to do something very similar to that, it wouldn't have to be a full blown building. It can be set up however, you know, two wide, two deep, three wide, two deep, however they want it. Then there was talk about taking some of the quads that are coming out of Deerfield Academy that should be available within the next 6 months to a year. That can be
That could be your offices.
Reconfigured into your offices, could be reconfigured into your restrooms, your showers, your bunk room, the whole nine yards, in a small office. But when it and we have already said that if they were to do something like that over there, if they've got a larger audience that they need more room, we're more than welcome to. They're more than welcome to come in and utilize our larger conference room.
Yeah.
For their trainings or their meetings or whatever it needs
like
be.
Always been.
But again, this is kind of going back to why are the people of the district going to put it on our backs to once again help out Waitley, Sunderland, Old Deerfield?
And I think part of the thing is it's not just can we fit a second ambulance. I think it's to give them the space that they need. I mean, one person sleeps in a blow-up mattress in this corner. Another person sleeps on a pull-out couch in their office. So, I mean, they don't even have true bunk space.
Let me ask you a question. Why do they need bunk space if they're working 8-hour shifts?
You're going to talk to Skims about that.
Yep. I mean,
you got to talk to Skims about
this
that.
This room here on the original print was sleeping quarters for a fireman.
For a fireman, if it ever came to that.
Right? If it ever came to that.
And it's going to eventually, you know.
Someday it'll come to it, yeah.
And eventually there'll have to be a wall right here because you're going to have male and female sides.
Well, don't you know that in the colleges now, they have co-ed rooms?
Yeah, no, they don't work here, though.
Oh. Well, let me tell you my second
one. It may work in the college, but it doesn't work in the workplace.
Yeah. How do you know it doesn't work here? Have you tried it?
Doesn't work here in the work. It does not work in the workplace.
He wouldn't have a job here if he had that. My second issue was the RFP that the town put out looking for ambulance space. Mm-hmm. And all I'm looking for there is to see if we can get you guys to work together with the town people, the selectmen, to see about using that 7 acres that we got out there. Because there is a lot of land out there.
That's a town land. That's not our land.
I know, but the town.
We would always like to own it, but it's not ours.
I talked to Carolyn the other day, and she says that she's willing to do whatever it takes to try and help get that thing developed. There are ways that we can turn around and probably ask people to help putting a building up there, which can help utilize some of your equipment in there, along with maybe the third ambulance if necessary, and put the quarters out there that you were talking about for sleeping quarters or whatever they need there, restroom, sleeping quarters, office. Mm-hmm. And they have an RFP, which is due on June, right here.
Can I see that just for half a second?
June 3rd, rather.
They asked for three bays.
That's just what I was going to look for.
Yeah, I mean, you know, and part of this whole thing
is also required to be in Deerfield.
Yeah.
My understanding is.
I read it.
Is when we as taxpayers for the town of Deerfield voted on this service for South County EMS, we voted for two ambulances.
Right on.
So the third one got put in there, and it keeps getting. That's
the Board of Oversight. They just figure, you know what it is? Everybody on that Board of Oversight has one idea. This ambulance service is more important than anything else. Put all the fat you can into there. Keep all the money. Don't give anything back. That's why I argued on town meeting floor to try and get back the $57,899 they owed us for 2015. And when I said that, I got chastised. I got assaulted after the meeting. And that's ridiculous. The bottom line is that they owe the money, and even our own people won't fight to get the money for us. And then they turn around and stand up on town meeting floor and say, oh, well, this goes back 3 years. Well, guess what? Skems wasn't here 3 years ago. That's an out-of-date bill by 10 months. That's all it is. But they don't know the facts. They don't know what's going on. And they just figure there's a deep pocket out there, and they can take whatever they want. And that's my concern. They have not shown the proper restraint that's necessary for running that, where you guys have. Big difference here between here and there. And they think they're doing a great job. But they want just gimme, gimme, gimme. And what do they want? They drew up a RFP for one thing. They want to have three open bays. You know why? Because a building in Whaley has three open bays that they can park three ambulances.
And the old fire station,
and they want
has two.
All the open space in there. You know why? So they can custom build their own thing. So they can turn around and have a director's office, an assistant director's office, and then they can turn around and have a kitchen, They can have a living room, they can have two bedrooms, they can have showers and everything else. Because they figure it's an endless supply of money. Since you got this thing, why would Whiteley not vote for everything that goes in there? They're paying 16 cents on a dollar. They can vote for anything because they're getting away with it. And their ambulance, the first one that they're going to replace is Whiteley. So they're getting an ambulance for 16 cents on a dollar. Why wouldn't they vote for it? Why wouldn't someone vote for theirs? I see problems with Skems the way it is. I see a lack of attitude where they want to change it. They just want to keep it rolling and keep it going and keep asking for the money, and they figure nobody's going to say anything. The only thing I'm trying to do is I'm trying to barter in between and see where I can get something to try and smooth out the wrinkles that are out there, and some of them aren't working.
Well, going off the RFP, we would need to be able to give them three bays, each one 13 by 27, which is 1,053 square feet. That would take.
I'm not looking for you to do that. Right. I'm only asking for one thing.
Right.
I'm asking for you to send a letter into Town of Deerfield and say, let's negotiate on something for the land out there. Maybe they can turn around, put up a building there, and maybe we can turn around and end up with two ambulances here and one out there or something. I don't care what happens. Right. I don't care what the negotiation is. I just want to see a willingness to talk to them and figure out what's best for keeping our ambulance in town. That's all I want to do.
But the town is going to need a right-of-way through the front of this building to access that property, because it, I don't believe it's included in the current title the Town of Deerfield has.
Which I don't think there would be an issue whatsoever with the district to allow that to happen.
I mean, we don't have to, but they would have to go through us in order to access the property.
And I just want to say that up front.
There's a right-of-way out here, and we just shut that one off because that...
I'm talking about the one.
You're talking about the one in front.
Right, that's correct.
And I don't see that as an issue either.
No, I
don't see that.
I just want to make sure that this
I think as long as it's for public safety.
There'd be no issues whatsoever. See, the only problem is we cannot respond to the RFP because we will not meet the specifications that they're looking for.
But you can enter into a separate intermunicipal agreement with the Town of Deerfield relative to providing the space, regardless of their RFP.
Yeah, that would be something completely different.
Yes, correct. And correct. You can do that. And that's completely permissible between the two entities.
Right. But again, kind of going back to originally what we're, and I'm not sure if you were here when we first started talking about it.
Probably not.
Year three, they were to be finding someplace else. And it's not because we were kicking them out. It was because, once again, like Billy says, they're growing.
They're outgrowing
our space already. So, and if they're going to be adding another ambulance in here, so now if you're going to be running two shifts, three shifts, again, just more wear and tear on the station.
They're running three shifts right now.
Right.
They're not growing anymore. You have two people per shift.
Well, actually, they already have, because now you've got more additional personnel from 10 o'clock to 6 o'clock now. Because that's
their prime time.
Exactly. So they're still adding.
They're going to do was they're going to have the second ambulance available.
Right.
So the chief was going to turn around and stay back there doing his paperwork down at the town hall.
Yeah.
And then come down here if a second tone goes out.
So
which brings me to another question. Have you ever used that Prudential committee room at the end of the hall?
They use it all the time.
We're updating it now. There's a new computer system going in. We're trying to get everything squared
up. Because when I was here, we never used it in 15 years.
Yeah, no, it's being extremely well used.
Okay, good. I want to make sure we get true value for what we're paying.
Oh, we do. There's no doubt about it.
In fact, they said there's not enough room in that room for what they're doing.
No, we're not going to have any additions for that.
Can I ask a question? It's always been my understanding that the idea of somehow or other merging the two fire districts just wasn't going to happen because of the differences in the way the structures.
I've been on three different committees to try to work that out, and it all ended up the same way.
I was going to ask it. Billy, you mentioned it. Has there been any change in that?
No, part of it is, I think you need to have an independent.
Look at it again.
We're hoping to look at it again.
Okay.
And I think it needs to be someone independent to come out here, and you can throw the egos, you can throw the history, you can throw all that out the window, and have someone come in here that's not biased, take a look at it, and see what makes the most sense. I mean, we're not getting the volunteers, people signing up like we used to. They're not getting them. So, I mean, it's the way of the world. I mean, Turner's Falls Fire is looking at the same. They just added, I think, two additional people, you know, because they don't have the call force they once had.
But my thought was, you know, if you end up with that ultimately merging, then I would assume that somewhere along the way you would also be looking at a small full-time staff, whether it's two or three people or what. Mm-hmm. At that point in time.
Well, actually, in January, we were going for the second fireman now.
You are?
Yes.
So it seems like it makes...
Try to back up and follow through with all the stuff with Dennis, so there's no mm-hmm. lack in communication, and everybody follows through and know what all the procedures, all the recordings, and all everything else is going on. And also with the inspections today. A lot of places take two people to go.
I agree.
And the laws are changing,
so if
not
going,
for the better.
If you're going
for,
that route,
yeah.
if you're going that route here with two people, it would almost make sense to take another look at merging the ambulance service in with the fire department. For staffing, if for no other reason, could we do a better job of staffing both the fire department and the ambulance service?
We're in 100% agreement.
Are you saying getting rid of the scabs?
You know, I think...
Well, to
go along exactly what you were talking about, Skip, we completely agree. You know, because realistically, if we can go ahead and we can bring some EMS within the department, okay, that's going to help fund the department. That's going to help. It's never going to be. We're never going to make money because, like Jack says, you know, it's you're always losing money when you're providing a service. You know, mm-hmm. The fire department loses. The EMS loses. There's never going to be a profit. But you know what? It's going to help take some of the sting out.
Yeah.
But you know what? That's not a...
No.
Okay, paramedic, 24/7, 365.
You're willing to take a look at
it. It's going to be a three to three... Seriously, if this is something that we're seriously looking into, it's going to be a 3 to 5 years to be able to seriously put it together so that way we are not, like Bill said, we're not in the same situation mm-hmm. where we're chasing our tail because we don't have everything together yet.
I think that's when we instructed the selectmen in town is, you know, what was being thrown around at first was a 10-year lease with the town of Waitley. And I said, you know, absolutely don't enter into a 10-year lease. If you can get into anything around 3 years or something like that, that gives that next step to say, okay, it gives us a little bit of cushion to do the research we need to do on our end, you know, and then have as many answers as we can leading up to it.
Because they can't go any more than 3 years without going to town meeting. Any type of lease or agreement, and correct me if I'm wrong, because I know Bruce would know.
I think, you know, and they would be...
They are creative.
I don't know that they can. I think if you look at the agreements that we have now, it requires town meeting approval to move the ambulance.
To fund it, and it requires...
No. Can they change that?
I bet they'll never vote to let this leave the town of Deerfield. There's too many people against that.
Just out of curiosity... If this drags on, so rumors started last time around that you guys were trying to throw the ambulance out until there was a meeting of the minds where it got publicized that you never were trying to throw us out anyway. But these are the rumors that people started throwing out, you know who they are. If this drags on a bit, you know, would you continue to house the ambulance for another year, so another rumor don't start out that we have to be out of there next year, they're throwing us out, and
no, I think
because this is what's happening.
It's negotiable.
Yeah, we already gave them year
right.
four.
Right, and I understand, but I just want this on the board because this is what happened last time.
Yeah, but
you guys were painted as the bad guys, that you were throwing the ambulance out, and we had to move. And no, I just want that on the table.
We said we're open to listen to anything.
I know you were.
Right. Yeah.
And I know you were, but I just want it out on the table.
Yeah.
You know, because... Last time rumors got thrown around.
Yeah, and I appreciate you bringing that up because that was pretty ugly for a while.
Yes, it was.
Yes,
and you guys were the royal ones,
right?
And it was crap, you know. And but that's what got thrown around. And I agree with Bill that one of the first questions I asked way back when, before this thing went on the table, how about finding a home before you get into this? Oh, we don't need that. We'll worry about that afterwards. And this is just what's happened. It's behind the eight ball, and nothing's got done. And now we're getting an argument. The other thing is, if something could be done out here, whether it be by the town or with you guys or whatever, it would still keep the tax dollars in town. right now, Wheatley is the only one that's paying for skimps. Sunland gets back more money than they pay in for rent. Deerfield gets more money back, although it comes back through to the fire district rather than the townspeople. But, you know, they're paying in, well, whatever. It's a positive. It's a positive flow. Right now, the only town that's actually costing money is Wheatley. If at least if it stays in Deerfield, it won't come back to the district, and of course the district will have to raise their rates, but it'll be offset on the general taxpayer rate if it stays in Deerfield. If it goes to Wheatley, Deerfield will lose, well, you'll lose your $36,000 rent, plus whatever it costs for capital outbuild and everything else down there. Sunland lose their $10,000. The only one that's going to make is Wheatley, and if you just follow the paper through, evidently some commitments were made that because it was presented to the townspeople before it was even bought that that's where the new home of the ambulance was going to be. So it's been very not very pretty right from the beginning, especially this home.
That was the one thing.
The politics have been terrible on this.
When they turned around and lied and said they're being thrown out. Mm. And like I said, I was a selectman for 18 years. And for 18 years, I never had to lie. Why are they lying now? And why are people accepting their lies? And I was glad that we had that meeting with you guys to clear up that issue, because that was very important. Because if you were throwing them out, then I was going to be very upset with you. And I'm glad I didn't have to be. Well, you guys
appreciate that.
No, and I told you that night that you did a great job, and yep. You did do.
Yep.
You know, this is the professionalism I'm talking about, because I've always seen that in the fire district. You know, I was part of it for a long time, and I saw that same professionalism and commitment that I don't see at the other end. That's what bothers me. So anyway, my two proposals is number one, see if you can sweeten the pot a little bit by lowering it a little bit. And number two, to be willing to talk to the town of Deerfield about something of mutual interest with that 7 acres of land out there. That's all I got. And
I always figured that was a spot to set up, because it coincides with the services over here. It's
absolutely
right next door and everything else.
But. Yeah. So, and I've heard rumors.
How you go about it is another thing.
But that's right. But that's why we need time keeping the ambulance here until we can figure out how to do that.
Yeah. Well, we're only into year two right now. We're going into year three.
That's right.
So, year two, that's right. And you got two more that you agreed to.
And you still got two more. So.
And then we'll listen if there's
so
more
to
needs
out.
To be done. But, of course, I won't be here after another year, but that's all right.
I think I would like to see your board respond to the RFP and in writing that you can't do much more than what you're doing presently, mm-hmm. but that you want to make. You're willing to offer them a right-of-way to go to the town's property over here to set it up and expedite whatever needs to be done. Mm-hmm. And whatever else that you informally said that you would be willing to provide the space out here for the meeting room, mm-hmm. and what have you. So at least you reply to it, because I got a feeling that this thing is set up, this RFP is set up to fail in Deerfield.
Right. That's right.
And you need to cover yourself.
I understand.
And,
it was set that RFP was set up so that knowing that it probably could not go in Deerfield, and the Board of Oversight's going to throw up their hands and say, well, what do you want us to do? There's only one place that can comply.
And the other thing is, they wrote it so the old fire station wouldn't comply.
They wrote it so this one wouldn't comply.
Yeah.
Okay.
They wrote it. The other one would have been adequate space for it.
Now,
but they wrote it so it wouldn't, because they want to have three bays.
A reply is necessary on that, because those are the specs, but if you read the back end, they're all rated most advantageous, et cetera, et cetera. So that's not a concrete set of specs. Mm-hmm. Okay, and that's why I think with Bob's right, you do need to follow up with a reply that, you know, such as Bob said, this is the best you can do, but you want to work with the town to, continue, you know, with a right of way if they want to develop the building or
we'll be glad to do it.
Yeah.
But, you know, I think if you fail to respond to the RFP,
that may show that there's
lack of interest.
That's right.
Lack of interest.
And the main problem here is the deal was made in Whately, and it was a commitment made by certain former town officials, right? That Semps was going there. And whether it was person-to-person contact, or there was a memo, or it's in the minutes, I don't know.
But, or insinuation.
But there is people that serve on the Board of Selectmen in the town of Whately are sold on the fact that they were told that Semps was going there.
Right.
And
now what we got to do is call for a town meeting in Whately to find out what the real truth is.
Well, if you listen to the tape of the Frontier School Committee meeting the other night, you may learn things.
You know, it took 50 years to square away to vote in Frontier Regional School Committee.
One man, one vote.
They still don't know how to do it.
And they showed us how to do it. But the bottom line is it took a court order to require it be done. And then they finally did it.
They ignored the court order for a number of years.
I thought it was 1 year.
So I think, you know, the bottom line is the fire district is here to support the ambulance service. I mean, it's all about life safety first, property safe, you know, safety next. Yep. You know, so, you know, what we can do, we'll do our best, and, you know, we'll try to get something together and respond to the RFP.
Yep, I agree.
Okay, and it's got to be by June 3rd.
Yep.
Yeah, but it's gonna. I don't know if they're gonna require you to put up so much money to put the RFP in.
Nah, they won't do that.
Yes, you gotta make sure in your letter that you want to request it to be waived.
Excuse me, who made the RFP?
Doug Finn and Company.
So yeah. It's from the Board of Selectmen.
Yes,
and are they the ones that are going to
the Oversight Committee, technically?
But who's going to select the people that are going to judge it?
The Board of Selectmen, I believe.
No, the Board of Oversight. None of this meets their thing, so we can go to Whately.
Who scored the sale of the recent land in town? Did the Board of Selectmen participate in it? They didn't do it in open meetings. They did. Right?
What?
When they got the bids in on the properties that they sold,
mm-hmm.
Who scored that?
I don't
probably know. Town administrator.
Yeah, that was going to be my guess.
Yeah, but, you know.
But I think it was the town administrator who suggested or recommended to the select board, because the select board was the governing body that actually had to make the final decision.
Right. Yeah, but they did, but they sold property for less than the higher bidder, and, you know.
Yeah, that is correct, but that's them and... Not us.
So anyway, you can appreciate why I brought some of the smartest people in the town at Deerfield. They've all asked good questions.
Yeah, no, that's great.
You gave me a good answer. I'm still not satisfied with it. But I wanted to at least come down here and say, you know, we got to work together, and that's what we have to do. If we don't work together, we're going to fight each other and go in your opposite direction, and that's wrong. That's not what all of the bigger towns are doing.
Yes, sir.
We should turn around and work together. And like you say, it may take 4 or 5 years before we can see the fruit of our labor,
mm-hmm.
getting guys that are both dual trained as a fireman and as an EMT basic.
Paramedic
too. So whatever we've got to do.
How long do the appointments run for the Board of Oversight?
People are looking forward to having new people on in the 1st of July.
Usually they run for 1 year at a time, and they get reappointed each year. Are you interested in running? I'll talk to people that I know and see if we can get you involved. Because you know, one of my recommendations is this, that we get somebody from the fire district who really knows and understands. That would add a lot of quality to the Board of Oversight.
I'd be more than happy to attend the meetings. I don't think I need to be part of the Board of Oversight.
I think you would do an outstanding job. He's volunteered. Do we have volunteers?
It's a conflict of interest.
No, it's not.
That actually depends, Bill, because they had some tentative changes, and one of them was to change the board every 2 years. And with no more than 2 terms per member, which of course is not good because
not good management either.
Not good management, because that means they would all expire at the same time. Right. So you'd end up with
that's
a new.
That's not good at all.
Yeah. Yeah. But that was part of the tentative changes that they were looking at. And unfortunately, that does not require town votes. That's, that is the Board of Oversight.
In their opinion.
Yeah. That well, no, it doesn't. It really doesn't. It,
town council is ruled.
What they did was they turned around and called to make sure that they didn't have to do it. That's why they passed over the thing at town meeting. Article 25, because they didn't want the townspeople to get up in arms about what they were doing, how they were throwing them a dog bone and saying, here, we gave you one more vote, Deerfield, you got one more vote, you got three votes now instead of two.
So
you only got 43%, you still don't have 52%. We don't have our fair share of the votes. So they didn't want to hear that again. Anyway, that's all I have. Thank you for listening.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, Phil.
Appreciate y'all coming.
So we will
go ahead and reply to the RFP to include, you know, the right of way without an issue with the driveway, keeping the ambulance housed here as is, one ambulance, not two or three.
Yeah.
And until the town or somebody else decides if they can go ahead and do something with that property over there. Fair enough.
And even consider a little reduction. Just to throw me a bone?
Don't count on it.
You're going to
mention in your thing that the common the space out there for the meeting hall and stuff, and that stuff's available, and you're going to love music.
And they got sleeping quarters right here, and the Skems has to put in a petition.
No, I won't go quite that far.
We'll go buy a couple 2x4s, and some sheetrock. The fire code,
we could do that.
We get that done.
Sure,
a couple hours.
I know a couple of contractors that could do that really quickly.
You do, Honjo.
Yeah, you. Volunteer, see that?
And you'll do the
what? Anyway.
I just had one question for the board. Do you currently have employees that are paid, that get a regular payroll?
That's correct.
And you're all set up to do that anyways.
Okay. Right?
Correct.
Yeah. Do you guys buy insurance through the town group insurance trust? No. Health insurance? No.
Yes.
You do. But all the payroll stuff is separate. The town doesn't.
That's correct.
All
right. Yeah. No. We handle all our own internal. The only thing we rely on the town for is guidance as far as policies and procedures, because we pretty much try to follow the same thing that the town does. And
they've done that
insurance.
For years. Whenever they give a pay raise, they try and kind of match it to make sure they keep up with all the, you know, entities within town.
So we stay current with the town.
Yeah.
Well, the same thing what Skims is doing now is they're sidestepping that whole process too. They're trying to bring people in, you know, instead of going, you know, the pay scale raises, instead of going, you know, like $2, $3, $4, they're looking at $15, $20, and $25 raises. It's quite bizarre.
The problem is that they don't want to be controlled. They want to do what they want to do, and that's the issue.
One thing that when you guys were talking, you said, you know, you're not sure what they're doing. I think they know exactly what they're doing. And
you think so?
Yes, and I think a lot of their things is quite intentional. And from
I know some of the things, given some of the $5,000 raises was intentional, and I think given a $2,000 bonus was intentional, and I never gave a bonus for 18 years, so.
Yeah.
Maybe I'm cheap, but I'm conservative.
I don't know about no bonus.
I didn't get a bonus here.
We don't give them. I talked about proper management. You guys have it.
Did you ever give Mary a bonus?
Of course not. All I did was hug her up and say, Mary, you're doing a great job.
Okay, gentlemen, thank you.
See you later.
Okay.
See ya.
Okay.